Hello children, how are you all? Hope you all fine and safe. I am Mrs. Rani, science teacher. Today we are going to learn a new topic which will be more interesting and it will be very very useful for us to find out and identify many things around us. Okay, first before going to the topic, just I wanted to brush up and insist about the all safety measures, whatever the things we learned in our lessons, as well as last lesson we studied about the hand washing techniques also, isn't it? So are you all using the hand washing techniques? Are you insisting your parents? Are you insisting all your family members to follow? Okay, good. Not only hand washing technique, please children, don't go outside, avoid going outside. Okay, when you are going outside and any emergency, whatever the need, please wear mask and always you just follow the social distancing. Okay, good. Okay, now we are going to new topic, I said, isn't it? Okay, before going to the topic, just check out your room. Okay, wherever you are watching this video, just have a look of your room or the surrounding, whichever is near to you. Just have a look, children. What are the things you can find? You can find many things around you, isn't it? A sofa, even a mobile phone, maybe your parents or many other things will be there. Why I'm telling like a things? See, everything is made up of two things we have studied in a last year, isn't it? One is man-made thing and one is, what is the other thing? Do you remember, children? Yes. Natural thing and man-made thing, isn't it? Okay, good. So all the things are classified into natural and man-made things, isn't it? See, I have kept few things here. Okay, hope you all very eager to see what is this. See, Mrs. kept so many things in the table, isn't it? Okay, see children, kindly adjust. I don't have much more this. I'd like to show you more than this, but due to this lockdown, I'm unable to go out and get many things for you. Adjust with these things what I have exhibited here. Okay, back to the topic. When we are seeing the things, we can see and identify which is natural and which is man-made. That is what we learnt in the second standard, right? Okay, now we are going to do the same things, classification in a different way, that is solids, liquids and gas, right? Okay, this three classification we are going to just classify the items whatever is surrounded as. Okay, first before going to the topic, now I wanted to say that whatever the things, that is the matter, can exist as solid, liquid and gas, right? Okay, before going to this discussion elaborately, just find out and tell me what are the items are here. Each is different, isn't it? Yes, each and everything is different. And even I have a balloon here. See, if I'm not able to place it here because it's very big. Okay, kindly adjust. Okay, right. So why I wanted to show all many these things, you can classify in a different way. See, each and everything is different, right? Okay. See, if I'm telling you, if I have a water here, okay, I'm pouring a water. Okay, I'm keeping a tumbler of water here. Okay, a glass full of water, right? Okay. Now you tell me each and everything is different, right? I'm going to classify these items in a three classification, that is solids, liquids, and gas. See, gas we cannot see, isn't it? Yes. Okay, before going to this, first I'll explain about the solids. Okay, the things that have a definite shape, that is the things which will have a exact shape. Okay, and volume. What is volume? First, before going to the topic, we should know these words. Okay, a few words are there: mass, volume, particles. Okay, first I'll explain those things. See, all matters, whatever it is made up of particles. Okay, particles, the amount of particles only make the how much the particles made up of the matter only called as a mass. If I'm taking a one plastic ball and same size of tennis ball, which will be heavy. Have you seen a tennis ball, children? Have you seen a plastic ball, ordinary plastic ball? You can easily say that the tennis ball will be very heavy, isn't it? Because the mass which is consist of the tennis ball will be more. Understood? Okay, now you are clear with the mass. That is the how much the particle, the amount of the particle in a matter, right? Okay, next I wanted to teach you about the volume. What is volume? Volume is nothing but the space. See, if I'm keeping this onion here, isn't it? I'm keeping this onion or this Kit Kat chocolate or this two biscuits, I'm keeping here, it will take its own place, isn't it? It cannot be changed. It cannot be changed. Okay, these things, the matter which is called as a solids, okay, it will have a definite shape and definite volume. It will take a definite shape and definite volume. Okay, some brilliant children can say how it will take a definite size and shape, volume. If I'm eating this biscuit, okay, if I'm eating this half of the biscuit, the shape is changed, isn't it? Yes, I understand. Okay, this is also correct. Only the solids can change the shape or the size or the volume only if you are breaking it or you are cutting it. Okay, so the solids have that definite shape and definite volume. This is the first important thing you should know, right? Okay, next is the particle in the solid. That is whatever is made up of this particle. Yes, it's packed very tightly. See, you cannot change the shape by squeezing, by doing all actions. No, this is tightly packed. If you take your pencil, see, I cannot just change the shape. I cannot bend it, right? Right? Yes, your scale, pencil, your eraser, whatever it is, right? So, the solids have a definite shape and volume, okay? So, fixed shape, space, and whatever the things, particle in this, it cannot be changed. Rigid. It is very rigid. Rigid means not changeable, okay? And the next thing what we want to know, the particle is tightly packed in these things so that it cannot flow. Okay, what is flowing? Flowing, you know the word of flow, F-L-O-W, flow, you know the meaning of flow, isn't it? Kotrad. Okay, if I'm taking a water, see, I'm taking a glass of water. Okay, I'm keeping this here. Okay, I'm taking a glass of water. Okay, see, I have two tumblers here. One is stainless steel tumbler and one is glass tumbler. Please bear with me, children. I'm not buying plastics nowadays. I stopped buying plastics. You know very well, plastics are very dangerous to our environment, right? So, we should be very responsible of thinking all these things also, children. Okay? Okay. See, this will be heavy and this will be little lighter than this, isn't it? Because of the mass, the particle is made up of this matter. These two are what? Solids. Okay, this cup also I have here, it's a solid having a liquid inside, isn't it? What is liquid? The water. What I have now with me is water. Okay, good. Can you see? This water is flowing from this tumbler to this containers, right? Can you understand what is flowing? But this matter cannot flow like that, right? If I'm keeping the things here, it will stay there itself. Right? Because of the particle is packed tightly, it cannot flow. Now you can understand the difference between liquid and solid. Right? I think you understood about solid. Okay, good. Now I'll come to the next classification, that is liquids. We are going to learn about liquids. Okay? Okay. Liquids do not have a definite shape. That is, see, if I'm keeping in this tumbler, what shape is this? This liquid having shape of this tumbler, right? This tumbler is having different shape, isn't it? So, this liquid, what is inside water, is taking this shape. But if I'm pouring it here in this tumbler, it's taking the shape of this tumbler, right? The container where the liquid is poured, where the liquid is flowed to that, it's the taking its shape. So, no fixed shape for the liquids. Understood, children? Okay. So, no fixed shape, no definite shape, but it will occupy the space. See, I told you I took only one tumbler of water only, isn't it? This tumbler only. See, I'm taking again. I'm pouring to the same tumbler where I have brought here. Okay, from this tumbler. You can see the same amount, the same quantity only is there, but I am pouring to the different places, it's taking different shape. So, the it having, what it's having? Definite space. It takes the definite space. How much space it will take the, that will be there. So, liquids do not have a definite shape, but it occupies space. Okay? Understood, children? And the volume, that is the space, the volume the liquid takes, that is occupies by the object, same. Okay, same. Even the container changes also. If I'm taking a this is 200 ml of water, means if I'm taking small bowls like this, whatever the container, the 200 ml only I can share. Isn't it simple way? If you are getting 1 liter juice for your house, okay, you wanted to share to your guest, someone is coming to your house, 4 or 5 members, you will be pouring in a tumbler. Okay, you can share. Okay, you can flow, it's flowing easily, isn't it? So you can pour it in a tumbler and you are giving to the guest, and the 1 liter only will be there, right? Understood? So it not having a definite shape, but occupies the space, and it has a definite volume. Okay, understood, children? Now we are clear. Okay, good. We are coming to the third classification, gases. Okay, we are classifying the all the matters around us into 3 groups: solids, liquids and gas, isn't it? So gas means whatever the using the smoke, gas, the pollution, air pollution. When the bike, if you are going to the in the roads, you can see the smoke which is emitted in the vehicles, isn't it? All those things are called as gas, isn't it? Okay. Before talking to the example, just I wanted to say about this properties of gases also. Okay. In the gas, the matter in the gas are very loosely packed. That is, see, if in the solids, the tumbler or whatever the matter items, the solid items I showed you, it has a very tightly packed particle. So it cannot change. It cannot move. It cannot flow. But in the liquid, the liquid can flow. Okay, but it's not having a definite shape, isn't it? But in the gas, okay, if I'm not tied this properly, okay, see, I blowed in the balloon, okay, I kept the inside, what is inside, children? Air, isn't it? So this air is an example of gas, okay? See, if I am, see, you can find out in this, see, I have a bottle, water bottle here, okay, a bottle, I just inside a balloon here, okay. You can say that, is there anything inside this bottle, children? No, nothing is inside, isn't it? But air is everywhere, isn't it? We studied air is everywhere, air present in all the places, okay. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to show this small simple act to show you that the matter in the gases are very loosely packed so that it can move around freely in all directions. That is, see, if I'm pressing the bottle nicely, the balloon is getting bloated. Isn't it? How, what happens? What's happening here? The air which is coming inside in the bottle, okay, it's going and filling in the balloon. So, it's moving towards the balloon and it's making the balloon blow. Okay, right? Yes. So, the matter in the air, that is the gas, very loosely packed, so can move freely in the direction where we are showing, right? Okay, if it is not tied here, what will happen? The air will escape any direction, it will go out, isn't it? Understood, children? So the gases do not have a definite shape. Wherever we are filling it, if you are filling the air in the vehicle tires, okay, the balloons, okay, or if you are going for theme parks, you can see a big castle or big things will be made up of, no, air cushion like things they could have made. Okay, you all go and jump and play in that, isn't it? Have you seen all those places, children? Have you went those places? You'll enjoy those places, isn't it? And we'll be, nowadays we are getting a small swimming pool. You can blow the air and you make the swimming pool ready. Okay, small, just it'll be like a made up of plastic, isn't it? So those things, when you're filling it, it's taking that shape, not definite shape of the air. The amount of the air you're blowing, it's taking the shape of the container where you are throwing inside. Okay, so this air, whatever inside the air, amount of air which is inside the bottle, okay, it's taking the shape of balloon. Understood? Yes. Okay, good. So air do not have a definite shape and do not occupy definite space or volume. Okay, with all those explanation, I hope you all understood about the properties of solids, liquids and gas, isn't it? So the three states of matter only we are learning in this second lesson. Okay, so this is the second lesson, states of matter. Okay, children, solids, liquids and gas. Solid, liquid, gas. I have seen you, I have shown all the things, items, okay, the tumbler, biscuit, chocolate or whatever it is, the pencil, okay, sharpeners, whatever it is there, okay, these are the solid items, isn't it? The solid items. And the liquid, I showed you water, isn't it? It's a liquid, okay? And the balloon, I blowed up with the help of the water bottle, just pressing it, okay? The air moved the balloon to blow, isn't it? That is the example of gas, okay? Now, I have listed off few more examples here, like solid, pencil, bag, board, okay? Liquid, water, juice, oil. Okay, even you can, nowadays we are using hand sanitizer, that is a liquid. Okay, hand washing lotion we'll be having, no, in our house, isn't it? Those things are liquids. Okay, so liquid will be in that sticky form or different form. The nature of the material also will differ. Okay, in the solid also we can see the hard materials, hard solids, and as well as the very flexible, but it will be very solid, actually said to be a solid. Like if you take a plastic, okay, it can bend but it cannot broke, isn't it? Understood? So like that, solid also you will having a difference. These things you will study in your future classes, children. Okay, then gas. Okay, finally this third classification is gas. Okay, wind, smoke, cloud. Okay, wind, smoke, cloud is a few example of gas, right? Apart from this wind, smoke, cloud, even the spray, we are using the body spray, perfumes and all, no? You can see the body spray, no? That is also example of gas, right? And water vapor, specifically water vapor is the best example of gas, what you can see easily. Because of that tiny water droplets which is in the water vapor, when it's very easily you can see when your mummy is preparing idli, okay? Ask mummy when she is preparing idli, just ask her to show you when she is opening the lid of the idli cooker or idli pan, whatever it is. Just don't go very near. Stand next to your mother and watch what's happening, okay? Next, actually what will happen when you are opening the lid with the heat of the water, when you are heating with the help of this stove, okay, the water is getting heated and it's converting into water vapor, isn't it? That tiny water droplets with the air, okay, that is called water vapor. That is an example of, okay, gas, right? Understood, children? Okay, this changing is there. No, that we'll learn in the next class, actually. Okay, now we have to know these three classification and the example of these things. Now you try to find out in your house what are solids you have in your house, what are the liquids, what are gas you are around us, right? Okay, the properties of matter, this only I was explaining by showing that different types of matter, that is solids, liquids and gas, okay, those examples, okay, those items what I showed you, know those things only, the chapter properties of matter only I was explaining you, okay, children. Okay, in this basic, these properties only I was trying to teach you. So learn this very clearly and understand it. Okay. Rigid. I said the solid will be rigid. What is rigid, children? Not changeable. It will be same as it is. If I'm taking a biscuit, okay, I showed you a biscuit, isn't it? If I'm taking a biscuit, until or unless if I cut or break it down, it cannot change its shape and the size, isn't it? Shape, size, and as well as volume, where, how much space it takes, it cannot change. Understood, children? Okay, next. Next, it's taking the fixed shape and fixed volume. So, this three is very, very important. Solid, rigid, fixed shape, fixed volume. Understood? Liquid. Not rigid, okay? The liquid cannot be rigid, isn't it? If I'm filling in a water bottle or tumbler, it will be just, it can move, isn't it? If I'm shaking, it will move. It cannot stay in one place, isn't it? So, it's not movable and all, not, we cannot say that, right? Okay, next, no fixed shape. It's not having any definite shape, children. It can take any shape where the container, whichever the container, it's having a different shape. It will take, the liquid take to the same shape of the container, okay? So, no fixed shape. Next, fixed volume, but it's having a fixed volume because I told you the example, isn't it? 1 liter juice, if you're buying, you're sharing with 2-3 guests or 4-5 guests also. The same 1 liter only you can give, isn't it? It cannot change the amount, that is change the volume, the space, what it take, it won't be changed. Understood? Okay, next, gas. Okay, it's not rigid. Okay, it's not rigid. It can change and move, it can flow very easily because the particles are very loosely packed. Particles are very tightly packed, particles are loosely packed, gases, the particles are very loosely packed. Okay, that's why it's not rigid. And no fixed shape. Okay, it's not having a fixed shape and no fixed volume. Okay, for the assignment, okay, this is the time for the assignment, okay. The questions, whichever is involved, whichever is covering with the topic, what we learned, that is the types of matter and the properties of matter, isn't it? Types of, what are the types of matter, children? Solid, liquid, gas, isn't it? Next, what is the properties of matter? Just I taught you about the, with the things and as well as the flow chart I have showed you, isn't it? So, these few questions involved in this two chapter, and I'm going to give that. Which of these is a solid, wood or juice? Which is a solid, children? Wood or juice? Wood is a solid, isn't it? So, you have to write wood here. Okay. Which of these is hard? A sponge or a glass or a cloth? Which is very hard? Sponge is hard? No. Glass is hard? Yes, it is hard, isn't it? A cloth is hard? No, it's not very hard, isn't it? So, glass will be the answer. Next, what are the three states of matter? Just now I told you, what are the three states of matter? Solids, liquid, gas. Okay. And in which states of matter, the particles are very close to each other? Which states of matter, particles are very close to each other? In what, I told you, which material, the particles are very tightly packed? Solids, very good. So, in which states of matter means it's a solid matter only. In the solid state of matter only, the particles are very closely packed. Okay. What are the states of matter in rain? What is the example of rain, children? Rain is an example of what? Liquid. Very good. Okay. So, the states of matter is rain. What is the state of matter is rain? Liquid is the state of matter of rain. Okay, understood? Which among the states of matter has definite size but no definite shape? It having a definite size but no definite shape. It's a liquid, isn't it, children? It having a definite size will be there but it don't have a shape, isn't it? So, liquid. What are the some properties? What are the some properties of pencil? See, they are asking properties of pencil. Okay. If I'm asking what is the properties of pencil, first find out what is the matter. This, what is the classification it's coming under? That is, pencil is a solid or liquid or gas? It's a solid. Very good. So, pencil is a solid, isn't it? So, when we are writing the some properties of pencil, first we should write the properties of pencil are, it's a rigid, okay? It has, It has fixed shape and fixed volume. Okay, understood, children? Hope you all understand this topic easily. Okay, these questions I'll write neatly and I'll send you a photocopy also. Okay, so no need not to worry. Just copy that notes and this notes will be a continuation. Once I'll complete the other chapters, that is inside this lesson, what are the other chapters are done. Okay, I'll give the related questions so that we can complete the lesson as well as the notes together. Understood, children? Okay, hope you all understand this concept very easily. Thank you for listening, children. Bye.